recording.
Call the regular board meeting for the Village of McHenryville to order at 6:30 PM on Tuesday, March 27, 2018. Please rise, join me in the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Anybody want to talk about gun rights? On just kidding. Roll call, please.
Okay, Mayor John Daly. Trustees George Duperstein.
Here.
Kreese.
Here.
Heine.
Here.
Darrenowski.
Here.
George Ann Duperstein.
Here.
And Shinawa.
Here.
We have quorum. Motion to approve the agenda.
So moved.
Second. Roll call.
Trustees George Duperstein.
Aye.
Kreese.
Aye.
Heine.
Aye.
Darrenowski.
Aye.
George Ann Duperstein.
Aye.
Shinawa.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Anybody for public comments? None. Motion to approve the consent agenda.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Trustees George Duperstein.
Aye.
Kreese.
Aye.
Heine.
Aye.
Darrenowski.
Aye.
George Ann Duperstein.
Aye.
And Shinawa.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Reports and discussion. Mine is in the packet. I have no additional comments. Unless there's any questions concerning my report. Okay.
Excuse me, but I think that we should have reports spoken so that people who are watching the video have an idea of what the report was. Each of our reports, whatever.
It's posted on the website, is it?
Yeah, it goes in with the minutes on the website.
Oh.
So it is available.
Okay.
All right.
Just wanted to make sure that people.
Have access to it. Fair enough. Thank you. Madam Clerk?
We've been busy with business license renewals, and then I'd like to thank Deputy Clerk Roseanne Stark for covering the early hours and being here on election day. So, and that's it. Been busy.
All right, we're going to hold on finance and treasury just a little bit. Come back to you if you don't mind.
I'm fine.
Okay. Public Works. Oh, all right.
I've been still meeting with Mike DePaul on a regular basis. A couple of weeks ago, we took a tour of the Deer Crossing retention pond there and stuff like that to see what we can do, whether we could expedite a little bit better drainage going on and everything else. The mayor and I also took a walk over there and just came up that it would probably be best left if it was left for the experts in getting the right drainage, the right pitch and everything else, great, I should say. Also met with Mike and the other day, and we were talking about what projects are going to happen this summer, what he's looking at, whether it's tree removal, sidewalk repairs, and it was pretty intense. He's got a lot of work. He said he asked for an extra guy, he asked for one guy. He still has money left over from the budget from last year for seasonal, so he's going to ask to get a hire, well, he's going to hire the guy earlier so we can get started on these things. So Mike's doing a great job. Okay, and now here's Mike's report. We completed the cobblestone work on our entrance islands at Tall Oak and Cranberry Lake Drive. By having cobblestones on our island ends, it will save us money in the long run and time, and with and also time and labor, not having to water all summer long. Okay, he got with Chris Electric. Chris Electric has ordered the chlorine detector for the well house. Okay, this is a safety issue, and once he gets it, he will install it. He also thanked me for the work. I have to thank him for the work that he did also on the budget. You know, he's very meticulous and tried to get everything in there and, you know, make sure that we all knew what we're going for. So, and he also said, like he said, he has three out of the four seasonal hired already for the summer. He's looking for one more, and I think he has somebody in mind, but I'm not sure. So, but like I said, so he's looking for four people this year. And that's about it.
All right, thank you, sir. Any questions for Wally? Community events, Georgia.
I'm continuing to work on stuff for the reenactment. We have a meeting of the principals scheduled for later in April, probably around the 24th, and we'll get together and then work on the site again. Starting the publicity stuff.
Can you give him the microphone?
Oh, yes. Starting the publicity outreach, and I should have been kind of tied up with other things lately, but I should have the letters to the donors out something either sometime this week or early next week. As an aside, I'm going to be getting in touch with the people at Grays Lake. Apparently, they have a new program to get people moving from a health standpoint. They've asked us to participate. I'll probably have some kind of article for the newsletter at the end of the week and getting an idea. They also asked if we might have a booth at their kickoff event in 6th of May. Have to pin down exactly what they're looking for, but I'd be certainly willing to man it if, you know, it comes to that. Or whatever, you know.
Yeah, till we find out.
Yeah. Let's see. We have a meeting scheduled in a few weeks about the Memorial Day Parade, so I'll be going to that. And then we have some swabble stuff coming up that I'll be working on.
Very good. Thank you, sir. Any questions, George? Wetlands, Great Age Club, Georgia.
Yes, for the Great Age Club, some of the members went to Navy Pier to the flower show. Apparently, they had a really nice time. It was a nice day. This coming meeting, which is the first Thursday of the month, we're going to do Games and Gab, just a chance for people to visit and play dominoes or whatever. On the wetlands, I've submitted two grant applications for the what we're calling the gathering place, which is north of the Village Hall Pond. So we'll see what happens with that. There's a contract for work in the village that's under business. The welcome packet that we've been working on for months is nearly finished.
Okay, thank you. That kind of covers the ad hoc committee, new resident pamphlets. Right now I'm sitting on my desk for what will be hopefully the final edit. Chief Berlini, what do you have for us?
I'd just like to say that now we're in the throes of spring. Motorists can be careful. We're having construction in Grays Lake and Hayesville all along 120 and 45 all the way down here to Hayesville Road. There's been some on and off problems with the temporary lights. We've done our best with the maintainer to try and solve those problems. In addition, watch out for pedestrians, bicycles, motorcycles. We'll shoot and match because another couple of weeks. Hopefully we'll have some decent weather and we'll all be able to enjoy. That's it.
All right, thank you, sir. Finance.
So, everybody got the draft, also the, did everybody?
Yes,
everybody got the draft in their mailbox today?
John, you need to talk into the microphone.
As well as the overview spreadsheet, which shows he kind of top-lined what we are proposing for the balanced budget for this coming budget year of 18-19. So, does anybody have any questions about what they're reading? If not, I'm going to leave it to Kelly to kind of give everybody an overview of what they're looking at.
I know Trustee Creese already has questions. He has that look on his face.
He was born that way.
I have a question too, but I'll let you do your pictures.
Okay, I'm just going to do a little highlight of the whole spreadsheet. Basically, what we'd like to do is take all the information from the budget request forms and we put it into the budget report, which is what was one of the items that was emailed to everyone, and it's the blue line report. All the requests, these are all detailed information of how all the monies come about. Then I take and put it into the spreadsheet so we can see what needs to be trimmed, what we need to do, how much might be coming from savings and transfers and such. So looking at the first section, the general fund. The total budget requests, I broke them down to the administration, streets, police, EMA. I need to cross out EMA, that's an old thing. And the police. So you can see our total budget general fund requests were a little over 2.0 million. We put a contingency of 3% this year. In the years past, we've had 3% contingencies, 4%, and some 5%. This year, we're putting 3% in. The contingency is to, you know, we know there's projects that are going to happen or things that need to get fixed that we don't have in the budget during the year. So we'll put that in, and then if and when that happens, we go through the proper channels of trying to approve those with the board and the finance liaison and the mayor.
Yeah, garage door openers that all need to be replaced at the same time.
Right. So that was part of a good example of what came out of the contingency right the current fiscal year that we're in right now. And then you get the total budget expenditures. The next column is the revenue. And you'll see in the administration, the green highlighted bar is 1.5. And then my notes at the bottom, within this revenue, I'm just showing to you guys to get it to the balance, is out of that 1.5, $141,043. That amount's gonna be transferred in from the water fund underneath our enterprise water and sewer. That's part of a surplus when we did the balancing. And we're gonna transfer that in to help cover for the channelization projects for this budget year. The other highlighted, under amount taken from savings, still within the general fund in the blue, $208,745. We're gonna take this money out of our savings account, so to say, in the general fund. We have the money, the Illinois funds account. And we're not saying we're gonna have to tap into the whole 208, but to get this budget balance, we feel comfortable if we have to use that full amount, we can. You know, during the course of the next fiscal year, we'll see how the revenues are streaming in and the expenditures and that. And, you know, some things, you've known me over these past years, whenever I do an estimate of revenue, I go very conservative. I like to have the, ooh, yay, we got some extra. I'd rather do it that way than the over budget and everything. So by doing all those expenses and the transfer of the part of the surplus from the water in there, and that we'll have a balanced budget for the general fund. On to the enterprise fund, which makes up the water and sewer and sanitation. You'll see the water and sewer budget request bolded in the red of the 1.1 mil. I have a couple of notes below.
Keep in mind, red does not mean bad.
No, it's just color code. I just needed something bold so everyone can see. One of the first notes were there in the expenditure, the total includes $166,900 surplus from raising water rates. Now, this amount is going to be deposited into the water capital reserve account. And so what I do is we have to list it as it's going to be an expense out of there to move it over.
Where is this excess?
So the $166,900 is derived at $158,000 from the raising of the water rates 2 years ago. So every year when we raised it up that additional $10, we committed to put $158,000 of that revenue into the water capital. This additional is proposed of a little increase of the next water rates if it's going to happen.
I'm sorry, it was in the first. When you said $166,000, where is it?
Okay, so if you look under the notes section.
Oh, I can't read it. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay. It's right here. All it says.
Oh, okay. There we go. Go ahead.
Okay. So the additional, the 158 plus the additional proposed, that'll all get moved over to the water capital. That's why you see that in the red, just a little note. Another note within there, the next one, George, this will be the second red item in there for Wally. I'm talking about the transfer of the $141,043. This is showing that we're expensing it out of the water to get transferred into the general fund. And this is going for the channelization project. And the third red notice within here for the expenditures for the water is an expenditure of $112,000 for the sewer televising and $39,308 for the final payout to the Washington Street Force Main project. These two monies are actually going to be coming out of our tap-on fees fund, and I listed that underneath our enterprise. And that total amount is $151,308 that we're going to take out of that account.
The $112,000 was an estimate for Robinson, but now that we're going out to a joint bid with a number of other communities, my belief is that we won't come anywhere near that dollar amount. But Kelly
had to put higher.
Yeah, Kelly had to put something there, so as John said, we want higher,
right.
Open ended cover.
Right. And the $39,000, this is like the third fiscal year of carrying over the Washington Street Force Main project. Even though it looks complete to us, Lake County's engineers are still doing the reviews and everything, we still owe that $39,000. Mayor Daley reached out to Lake County to find out, like right before the holidays, will we receive that invoice to pay our final portion by April 30th this year? And they assured us yes, and then we didn't get any invoices yet, so Mayor followed up again, and they said no, so we're carrying it over again.
It's been in the budget now 3 years?
I'm pretty sure 3 years.
Yeah.
Right. So those funds will be coming out of the tap-on fees account, which we have about, I didn't write it in here, $191,000 in there. Those funds have accumulated from when new development comes in, all the homes that were once you tap onto a water line or sewer line, those funds go into here, and it pays for the water infrastructure and stuff.
And those funds have been sitting untouched for a number of years.
Correct.
So our budget review this year got, well, what do we got this money for?
Yeah.
Let's use it on something productive.
Yeah. And so, like now with the sewer televising.
Pardon?
We could in public works, too.
Could have.
That enough.
So when you take all those revenues and the transfers and that and the amount taken from the tap-on fees, we have a balanced budget for the enterprise fund. The next section is the capital funds. The first one is MFT. We're anticipating, the budget request came at $165,000 to do all the street resurfacing for this next fiscal year. We'll receive in revenue right around $95,000 from the state. And we're going to take $70,000 out of our MFT fund reserves to pay for this year's road program. And so that'll balance out. And SSA, our budget requests are right around $21,000. Revenue, $21,000. But gives us a balance.
How much is in that?
The SSA? I just looked it up for Trustee Duperstein. Was it 31? 34. 34,000 right now, cash in make. That'll
is that in addition to
yes.
21,000?
Yes.
21 is what we bill for each, we assess each year.
Right.
And at one point we had stopped, if you remember. remember.
Yeah.
Because we had reached a point where we had enough, we felt we had enough money. We had then restarted it. We still have the 34 in reserve. We're still assessing for getting the 21. This year it's coming out null.
Yeah. We restarted it because we don't think we have.
We had to do that.
And then the final area, general projects reserve. What we did is looked at the budget request for the general fund items, and we determined there were $23,472 worth of items that we want to take out of the general projects reserve, our capital in there. And so that helped us balance the general fund portion, and we have that money sitting aside for that. And some of those items were for public works, new streetlight poles. I think there was four poles, four streetlight heads, LED units for that. And I know I'm missing a few other things. There was a couple other, AC units. The village has really surpassed our life on two AC units, air conditioning units for the village hall here. So we're gonna take that money out of there too.
A quick historical view, if you guys remember from the last number of years, we've been trying to spend down our, what I always call our savings account. Came in around $3 million and tried to get it down to 1.5, 1.2, got it down there and somehow wrapped back up, which is not a bad thing, but it's actually good. So that allows us to have these funds that we can, or the cash, so we can transfer and end up with a balanced budget. Yet still end up with 750 in investment in the CDs.
For the general portion, 750,000,
and various, we're still adding cash to our various capital funds.
We'll be adding into the capital for our enterprise fund, the water. Mm-hmm. Like I said, the
166.
I think so, yeah, 166 surplus. This year for the general fund, we're not adding into the general. We're hopeful to look at next year's and get a little bit more. But we still have a good cushion on there.
We still have 250? Around.
Around.
Kelly is not comfortable with around.
I've been dealing with so many different figures that
but
they're all getting
around. But we are around 250 in still a capital reserve, a capital project reserve.
So again, as a board, we've been doing well, putting money aside, building reserves for when we need them, funding projects that we have to,
yeah.
And still not asking too much more from our residents on an annual basis.
If anything, I don't think we've asked for regular.
We levy, we try to keep the levy low.
Yeah, we keep the levy low.
But, okay, nice job. John, Kelly, more, you need questions?
Yes, more questions. I know Trustee Georgie has got some.
In the past, we got the budget format was that it was just like the way we get our regular budget information. It not down to the next eyelash, but you saw all the different things in under public works and under general fund salaries and blah, 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 blah. Why is that not the way it is this year?
You do have it. Those were the items. Clerk Messler put a memo out with your board packet that those items were going to come later. Unfortunately, I was out for last week except for Monday. So instead of holding up the whole board packet and that, she sent the memo out. And then yesterday I did send an email. And in the email, I did give you
I got that.
This was the document that everyone should have had too in the email. And then the draft appropriation ordinance and the draft budget.
Okay.
So all those documents are there for you to review. And please, if you just need me to make a copy of them, I have
no
problem making a copy.
I just didn't download every single one tonight.
So these are the ones that they're showing later on the agenda as business items to the drafts and that, so that's why you have them all. This blue bar one, it's the budget report that I've entered all the requests from everybody into our software and printed one big thing, and it does show you everything and all the little notes about how we derived at the total within each account.
Thank you.
questions? No, she answered my question.
Okay, excellent.
So the next part of this is, we'll have a public hearing at the next board meeting?
Yep.
To review the appropriation ordinance, because the appropriation ordinance gives the village board the legal authority to spend the money. You need to have this adopted before the before your first 3 months into the next fiscal year. We have plenty of time. So the April 24th meeting, we'll have a public hearing, and then later on the night, we'll put these items on for the agenda for approval and passage. And from now until then, and even during the public hearing, if there's any changes that need to be made, please reach out to, you know, John and myself, and we can go through it.
But no more spending.
Please.
You weren't looking at me, were you?
No, I was looking firmly down at Polly's direction.
We're not sure what's gonna come up. All right, before that turns to battle, thank you. Need approval of an ordinance establishing a sidewalk inspection repair program.
Second.
Discussion, I'll open. I tripped across something that led me to talk to Greg Broom and Jim Rock and said, is this a good idea? Then I got a document from IML that had a template of sorts to apply. So Jim put it in to English to fit our village, and that's what you see before you. Discussion with IML, they indicated, of course, I am the insurance arm of IML, indicated that to have a policy and to have an ordinance that authorizes the policy helps us in case there is an injury somewhere in the sidewalk. And as you've read the policy, it says we will do our best to meet these, but there are a lot of factors that go into it, whether it's money, time, all that. But they have something to aim for and work on. Works better for us with our insurance company. Other discussion? Roll call.
Trustees George Duberstein?
Aye.
Kreese?
Aye.
Hine?
Aye.
Dernoski?
Aye.
Georgian Duberstein?
Aye.
And Chenoweth?
Aye.
Motion carried. Ordinance number 18-3-264.
Can I go back to my report? I neglected to mention the village cleanup.
Sure.
The village cleanup, our annual cleanup, will be Saturday, April 22nd. It's Earth Day. In the past, families have come out and worked as a family. It's a lot of fun. The next Saturday is the rain day. We have a pizza party here at the village hall afterwards. There are already members of the National Honor Society from the various high schools agreed to help, but we need residents to help. And also, if residents want to do work in their own specific subdivision rather than what we do it for sure, is Haynesville Road and the bit on Washington and 120 that's part of Haynesville, and around the path on Cranberry Lane. So if you have something that you want to do in your area, you can make arrangements with the village to come and pick up trash bags and latex gloves and vests in case you're concerned about traffic. And you can work in your own area. So if there are any questions, you can contact me at my village email, georgianduberstein@haynesville.org. But it's fun, and we need lots of help to make it happen. Thank you.
Need a motion to approve the resolution for IDOT payments for snow plowing for $35,700. So
second.
Kelly, can you explain?
I did enclose a nice memo. Before we can use any of that money, the board has to approve then we send this resolution to IDOT. They look and review and make sure this is an allowable expense to use, and once we get that permission, we can use. I'm a little delayed about submitting this to the board. I was kind of waiting out the snow season to see if we even needed to do this, and then, well, yeah, we need to do this. This item was budgeted in our current fiscal year 18, the 35.7 come out of MFT, and we just got the last of the little invoices from snow plowing, so.
Questions, discussion? Roll call.
Trustees George Duberstein.
Aye.
Kreese.
Aye.
Pine.
Aye.
Jaranowski.
Aye.
Georgianne Duberstein.
Aye.
And Shinawa.
Aye.
Motion carried. Resolution number R18-3-121.
Motion for approval of an intergovernmental agreement regarding billing for sewer and water users.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Trustees George Duberstein.
Aye.
Kreese.
Aye.
Pine.
Aye.
Jaranowski.
Aye.
Georgianne Duberstein.
Aye.
And Shinawa.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Need a motion to approve the intergovernmental agreement for building inspection and development review for the Village of Haynesville, Illinois. So moved.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Trustees George Duberstein.
Aye.
Kreese.
Aye.
Pine.
Aye.
Jaranowski.
Aye.
Georgianne Duberstein.
Aye.
And Shinawa.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Need a motion for the approval of a resolution waiving the bid requirements for 2018 Landscape Concepts contract.
So moved.
Second. Discussion?
Yeah, just have a quick question. On the whereas avoiding the bid process for landscaping will result in savings of the village time, expenses, and resources, to preclude any individual questions on that, do you think it might be advisable to have some kind of more succinct or detailed idea of what the savings might be?
I'm not going to get to, I can mention it right now. I don't have my spreadsheet with me, but the savings for comparative services from the companies that it did the last year to this particular contract is approximately $11,000.
I'm just wondering if it would be useful to put that in the document itself. I don't know, I mean, I, no.
I did the, I believe this is the one that I did, and then I had Jim Rock review it,
mm-hmm.
and he did not
say anything one way or the
other.
Yeah. We can consider it for the future.
Yeah. Okay, I would just
possibly as a whereas statement or something like that.
Because I know there might be some individual that would request an RF, no bid contract, and I just want to make sure that there's a rationale that is obvious to the casual observer.
Understood. Roll call, please.
Trustees George Duberstein.
Aye.
Kreese.
Aye.
Pine.
Aye.
Jaranowski.
Aye.
Georgianne Duberstein.
Aye.
And Shinawa.
Aye.
Motion carried. Resolution R18-3-122.
Need a motion for the approval of the 2018 Landscape Concepts Management contract for $49,540.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion?
Yes, I have a number of questions. I might state at the outset where I'm coming from on all this is the fact that I'm rather detail-oriented. I've dealt with a whole myriad of contracts while I was in service, some being a $100 million area. And I've also worked on a 100-page bid and contract for the initial deal with this. So that's kind of where I'm coming from. When I looked at it, I just have a couple of questions, basically. under the mow any areas. I'm just wondering if that includes some of the work that Public Works might have done before, is the question.
No.
Oh, so it's only those things?
Yeah, it's the only thing that we covered on the previous contract.
Okay. It mentions under the listing of particular areas, Canterbury Lake. I think we should make an editorial comment, correction, and say Cranberry Lake.
I would say that would be appropriate.
And I'm just wondering, when we say Cranberry Lake, sometimes people ignore the easement. And I'm just wondering if there should be some statement of Cranberry Lake and the conservancy easement, just to make sure there aren't any questions, so that when work is done, there's work done in there as well.
I will make sure that they're aware that, that if a burn is required for that conservancy.
It's not in the burn, but it's the herbiciding and seeding, which is not even mentioned anywhere in the contract that I could see.
Woodland restoration?
Yeah.
All right, but right now, just so I understand, under control of burn, your only suggestion was to put the proper name in there.
Well, yeah, under that, or I think it's mentioned twice. One is under control burn, and the other is under woodland restoration on the second page. It says Canterbury.
I see.
So it should say Cranberry Lake, and also the
conservancy.
Yeah, conservancy. When they list the woodland restoration on here, they outline the locations, and they don't mention anything about the Haynesville Meadow. Is there any indication that this contract would cover that?
George Ann, do you have any call from our meeting?
We didn't talk about Haynesville. Really, there's not a whole lot that needs to be done there. Some are deciding, but if nothing gets done this year, it won't be the end of the world.
If you'll make a note, I'll follow up on it.
Yeah.
If it's not, I'll check on two things. One, whether it is their intent to include that, or two, if it was missed, then it'll be an addition.
Okay. And maybe Georgine can address this, but there was no mention of any seeding at all in the contract. Do we have it, especially in the conservancy area, Eastman area, which is really pretty grody right now. They certainly need to do some mowing and herbiciding there. I'm just wondering if they, is there any plan to do any seeding?
My best response would be, if it's not in the contract, then it hasn't been offered. Because if we discern a need, I'll question it.
Okay. As near as I can tell in the contract, nowhere does it break out the separate invoicing of Cranberry Lake and versus the rest of the village.
They have agreed to do so.
Yeah, well, I see under that one section that has the payment information, even though it's not place else in the contract, they talk about breaking out the services performed, but not the location. And if they don't break it out by location, then we have a problem of what comes out of the SSA and what comes out of other funds.
They will break. I have spoken to them about that precisely.
Okay.
And I think George Ann might have been there at the time. I'm not going to say for certain, but it will be broken out. They understand that SSA has to be billed separately.
Okay. There is a difference in price of what we paid for the burn before, and it's something like 11 grand, and now it's only 7,400. This is fine, because we certainly want to see a decrease. But when I compared what we paid for woodland restoration, or what we say is the stewardship, in the past, for the whole village, it was like 29,000 and close to 9,000 in the Cranberry Lake area. And they say they're only going to spend $2,000 approximately in the entire village for the same work.
They're good, aren't they?
Yeah, well, I certainly don't object to decrease in funds that we have to pay and saving the village and the taxpayers' money. But if it costs us $29,000 to get something done and it's only $2,000 for the same degree of work, we have a problem here in what we're going to get for our money.
You're assuming that there's a problem. Is it, did we pay $29,000 every year for burns, or is that just less?
No, not burns. This is for restoration.
Did we pay that every year, or was that just last year, George?
I don't know.
We paid several thousand dollars every year. Many thousands.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to fall on my sword over it. I'm just wondering. I have a little concern when I see such a disparity that what kind of work are we going to get for $2,000 for the entire village when it was more than that for just the conservancy?
No, based on the vote of this board at the end of this discussion, we'll find out. I mean, I don't share your concern. I understand your concern. They certainly sat down with us and went through it and walked along with Mike. I believe they have an understanding of what needs to be done.
Yeah, well, as I said, I'm not at this point going to fall on my sword over it, because it's only a one-year contract, so we can see what will happen. I just wanted to get on the record my concerns.
Okay.
And we need to have some oversight of what they're going to be doing during the year to see if, in fact, for that $2,000, we're going to get it.
Well, one of the things that we have asked and expect is that they, in each bill, they tell us exactly what they've done. So we should be able to track, and Mike will be able to be in touch with them, and as will I, to document, or at least to keep a record of what is being done. And if they fall down on the job, I'll hold their feet to the fire. If this contract proves to be a bust, we'll look again next year.
Right. I didn't notice any, and maybe I overlooked it, any penalties in the contract if they didn't perform.
No, there are none, just like there haven't been in the past.
Okay. One other question. We're in the mow only section on the second paragraph. It talks about, as shown on the map provided. I didn't, maybe you have it, but there's no map in here that I can see.
Trustee trustees George Duberstein.
I will reluctantly vote in favor, just knowing that it's a one-year contract and with my questions and concerns noted.
Priest?
Aye.
Hein?
Aye.
Jaramaski?
Aye.
Georgian Duberstein?
Aye.
I'm sorry?
Aye.
And Chenoweth?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Okay, thank you. Need a motion for the approval of Clark Services contract for $11,810. This is for pond treatments.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Just a second, please.
One question. Pond treatments, was that including the aerators? Without, that's, the fountains are a separate contract.
That's a separate.
And that's a three-year?
Right, will be in our second year.
Oh, okay.
Trustees George Duberstein?
Aye.
Priest?
Aye.
Hein?
Aye.
Jaramaski?
Aye.
Georgian Duberstein?
Aye.
And Chenoweth?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Okay. Kelly or John, do you have anything to say about items 8, 9, and 10? Kind of covered in the presentation.
Yeah.
Give the board one more chance if there's any other questions on that. It's not an action item, it's just a discussion. These were all emailed to you. All right, I need a motion to enter executive session for the purpose of discussion. Personnel pending or probable litigation and or acquisition sale of property.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion, roll call. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? All right, so we're leaving this meeting at 7:18. A couple minutes if you need it, then we'll be in the conference room. We will return and there may be action taken after executive session.